So I've come over today and I've decided finally I'm going to knock these gas canisters on the head. They're not good for the environment, so they're going. And I have come up with a fantastic idea to use on my plot. Stay tuned. So what I've purchased myself is this mini log burner. Now I'm fed up of buying those canisters and they run out and they don't work the best in winter. So with this now, you know, it opens up a little tiny log burner. It comes with a flue as well. So eventually it will go in the shed and you can place your kettle on, your little frying pan, and just pour in some little logs that you've cut off your trees and your boundary fences. And that way, everything that heats and also cooks the water and the food in my plot will be free. It'll be cooked by using logs and bits of old pallets and things like that. So yeah, that's the plan, to use one of these. Let's set it up and let's put the kettle on, I think. You know what, I'm actually really pleased with this. It's steaming away now, and the good thing is you can just take it off, pop it on the side there, it'll still keep warm. And yeah, oh, I'm just really happy. And it is roasting in the shed, absolutely boiling. So I'm really happy. I'll get my coffee now, tidy. So you know what, this is the best cup of coffee I've ever had on this plot. Perfect, absolutely perfect. I'm so pleased with that purchase. So it wasn't a paid promotion or nothing. Bought it myself. Little cheeky Christmas present for myself. So yeah, Danny is one happy boy. So one of my next jobs will be to put the flue that comes with it, like the chimney, and it goes up through the stove and through the ceiling and up onto the roof. And that'll be one of my next jobs. So if you're wondering why didn't he do that, well, I haven't decided which shed I'm going to put on yet. It probably will be the other one, but that will be the plan, that it will have a flue and any smoke or whatnot will go through the ceiling and out of the shed. So those lettuces that I planted in, they're looking absolutely lovely. And if you can see, the water has soaked in so far in the bed, so they've got a good natural watering. I've got a bit of flea beetle issue here, I think, but the peppers, again, look at them, they're just crazy. This is so many peppers. So another harvest of them again today, so many, and they're huge, they're so big. So King of the North, my absolute favorite. The emerald kale is bushing out now really well, and it won't be long before these cloches will have to be taken off, and I'm gonna have to put a new sort of framework over and some netting, because otherwise the pigeons, God, they'll devour them within seconds. And also, while we're here, so I have got some little beans. Now, not many, and they're not big, but I think if I start these off about a week or two earlier next year, I think we'll have an extra crop. I can't remember what these are, but I planted them up as a bulb, I think. And they're still flowering, you know, start of November, and they're gorgeous. They're absolutely gorgeous. Now, I've never shied away from showing you the highs and the lows of my plot. And I was hoping to grow a lovely, huge, big crown prince pumpkin. The bloody hell is this? Honestly, it's tiny. So I really don't think I'm gonna have a nice big meal out of that. So I'm gonna class that as a fail, but it looks cute though, right? So the plan is that this is all coming out. The strawberries, obviously, I planted further up there, and these are gonna be donated to Mark because he wants to have some on his plot. But this was just, it was just too overcrowded. I mean, look at all the runners that have taken over. The strawberries have taken over in this plot, and yeah, because this was so enclosed with the grapevine and the pear trees, and everything else, you know, there's some blooming stingy nettles there. This area had become too shaded, and even I was avoiding coming down here. It was just too shaded. So the plan is that this has to have a lot of work done to it. The sun is absolutely blinding today. Right, let's get some of these jobs done. Thank you. So I try and explain to the older gentlemen further up the plot what no dig is, and they constantly keep giving me shovels, space shovels. And I haven't got the heart to say no to them, so I pass them on, but I'm no dig. So some of the garlic is starting to surface, especially over there. I've noticed some nasturtiums of, So some of the garlic have sprouted, but I've also noticed some nasturtiums down here that have self-seeded as well from this plant. So I'm gonna pot them up as well and they can overwinter in the greenhouse. And also, the strawberries, they've already started putting on new growth. So that's good that they've bedded in well. So it's really nice to see the plot now, you know, being nice and tidy. All the beds are now cleared to what I can do. You know, I've obviously planted things in. And it's just nice to see. It's always muddy and dirty and wet at this time of year, but you've got to make the most of it, right? So my next plan is to bark all the way through. You know, hopefully we'll have a few more bark deliveries and it should be nice, neat and tidy then, ready for spring. So also the shallots are coming out now and they're looking grand, I must admit. They're looking really good and healthy. So I'm really pleased by those. I think they're the golden gourmet. So I've got some extra garlic going spare that I bought from the Malvern Autumn Show, and this one's called Cadors. And I've got a bit of spacing in between the strawberry plants. So what I thought I'd do is I thought I'd plant these ones in, they're huge bulbs, and I've read that strawberries and garlic work well together. So I'm gonna get these in now. Right, let's get them in. So all the garlic's in, and I'm sure they'll work in harmony. I'm Danny and this is The Grapevine Garden.